while looking for poison dart frogs in the rainforest of Costa Rica. Yeah! The crew spotted a boa constrictor. He's large and aggressive, but not venomous. So he's perfect for testing out a new safety glove.
Jeez! And nothing. The psychology still freaks you out, but nothing went through the glove, so that's absolutely perfect. What I'm gonna do is grab this guy and move him to an open area over there so I can just get a little bit of blood.
Boas are at the top of the food chain in the rainforest. They can prey on monkeys and even porcupines.
Look at that! Ah. Look at those teeth! Ah! Oh, jeez! Ah. This is a heavy snake. And look at those, that's what I was talking about. These guys have those big teeth, no venom, but those teeth get into you, and that's gonna rip your flesh apart. You listen to that sound he's making, he's upset. That's no joke. And look at this, this is a defense mechanism in a lot of boas, which are boas and pythons, and that's basically, they make their tail look like a second head, and that's to make attackers get confused. And the organ of Jacobson, I obviously can never do this with venomous snake, the organ of Jacobson's in the roof of the mouth. You can see it looks like a pair of nostrils, and they'll catch scent particles and basically use it for smell. All I want to do from this guy is literally get a little bit of blood and have Devin help me.
There's ongoing scientific debates on how many subspecies of boa exist. I'll take a blood sample so this guy's DNA can be compared to a database of known varieties.
Just watch that needle. Oh, just try. Quickly get it out to tell you.
This guy looks like many other boas I've found,
okay.
But not all key gene differences are obvious. And over 100 new species are documented every year.
So that's all we need. Little touch of blood. And this snake's given everything that we need to get, so all we're gonna do is let go and go back to the dart frogs.